أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وما كان ربك ليهلك القرى بظلم وأهلها مصلحون، ولو شاء ربك لجعل الناس أمة واحدة ولا يزالون مختلفين إلا من رحم ربك، ولذلك خلقهم. وتمت كلمة ربك لأملأن جهنم من الجنة والناس أجمعين. وكلا نقص عليك من أنباء الرسل ما نثبت به فؤادك، وجاءك في هذه الحق وموعظة وذكرى للمؤمنين. وقل للذين لا يؤمنون اعملوا على مكانتكم إنا عاملون، وانتظروا إنا منتظرون. ولله غيب السماوات والأرض وإليه يرجع الأمر كله، فاعبده وتوكل عليه، وما ربك بغافل عما تعملون.
صدق الله العظيم، جزاك الله خير، بارك الله فيك. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا يا عظيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. I would like to welcome you all, inshallah, to this session number 8 with Sheikh Muhammad. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless him and give him, inshallah, the power, the knowledge, the time to share with us some of the Quranic lessons and benefits. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make the Quran always in our life and always guidance for us in this life and the hereafter. Inshallah, today I think Sheikh Muhammad will go over some maybe points and lessons over Surah Al-Furqan as a conclusion. Then, inshallah, he will introduce a new surah, Surah Al-Shu'ara, inshallah. So, Sheikh Muhammad, تفضل, go ahead.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وآله وصحبه والماله. All praise are due to Allah who put us together for a noble cause and good intention. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us and reward us, guide us, making us among those who are guided by the Quran, protected by the Quran, also guided others by the Quran and protecting others by the Quran. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the companions or the family of the Quran. I realized that the descriptions of Ibadur Rahman, I mean, there is no way you can finish it in one or two. There are people already written books and masters in it and PhDs, and there are a lot of mufassirin and so on and so forth. One of them is our brother, Dr. Ahmed Qaddour. He has a kind of a little book about also Surah Al-Furqan in general and Ibadur Rahman, and he is doing the final touch to it. And then, inshallah, we'll share it. He will share it with us, and it is a good research. He spent a lot of time in Surah Al-Furqan, read a lot of books about Surah Al-Furqan, and so on and so forth. So we are happy that we have someone who can really push us to the second stage in understanding Surah Al-Furqan and Ibad al-Rahman. Now, in understanding Surah Al-Furqan, I think we get good idea that assertion of who is Allah and how we are related to him and why he is the only one, and then why no one can be partner or helper or relative to him, and then presented why people rejecting the Quran and why people don't accepting the authenticity of the Quran or the authenticity of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then we know the surah have given us eight scientific miracles to prove to us that the Quran is from Allah. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah, truly, absolutely. Otherwise, no one can come up with all these, at least in this surah, eight scientific miracles. And those signs that are mentioned in the surah, they are basics for the living of human being. Can't life of human being on earth is impossible without those miracles and those facts, those proofs, evidence of the Quran. So they were miracles to prove the greatest miracle, which is the whole Quran by itself. Now, also, we realize, and this is especially Ibn Ashur, that whatever descriptions of Ibadur Rahman, it is only a way to mark those who decided not to be Ibad al-Rahman and to be Ibad al-Shaytan or Ibad whatever their desires and lust and so on and so forth. So it is in a different way telling us this Quran, this message, this prophet, and those miracles by the permission and the will of Allah have generated a generation of servant of Ar-Rahman. And we know the word Ar-Rahman is only exclusive to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We can't call anything or anyone Rahman. We can call someone Rahim, but we cannot call anyone or describe or give this quality and attribute to anyone except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Rahman is unique attribute to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the surah has given us a part to see his rahmah, given us many shows, many ideas, many thoughts to show us his rahmah, that he is calling upon us with his mercy, not with anything else. Definitely, there were hot potatoes in the surah. We just didn't go deep in them. One of them, as we said, وقال الرسول يا رب إن قوم اتخذوا هذا القرآن مهجورا. This is a complaint filed by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the to be looked into in the day of judgment in front of the judge Allah, the Lord of the words and the just. This from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the supreme judge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Against whom? Against those who have abandoned the Quran in many way, in any way, in any form. And definitely we know if the complaints from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the judge is Allah, then definitely those who are charged of this crime are going to be in deep trouble with no doubt about it. And so it is standing, and many names, Muslims, are in that list of being accused with these matters. There are, I think Brother Dr. Ahmed Qaddour will talk about the forms of ittakhadhu hadha al-Qur'an mahjura. But from the surah, we can tell exactly how Muslims ittakhadhu hadha al-Qur'an mahjura. Knowing Allah is weak, committing shirk is common among Muslims, maybe not denying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but either confused or unable to understand many of his verses, many of his attributes and names, and many things going around the world. So shirk is imminent. Many Muslims, وَمَا يَأْمُنُوا أَكْثَرُهُمْ بِاللَّهِ إِلَّا وَهُمْ مُشْرِكُونَ. And we have taken, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Quran Mahjur. I mean, we didn't study it just the way we studied Surah Al-Furqan. We found sections, ideas, proofs, evidence, bringing us close to Allah, enlightening us, and strengthening our iman and our understanding of who is Allah and how He is a compassionate and merciful Ar-Rahman, and how He sent His blessings with no limit to all His creation. So we did not really go through the Quran, at least the way we went through Surah Al-Furqan. That is mahjur. I mean, the rest of it you left for whom? The part of the Quran that you did not read or you did not understand, left to whom? How can you tell Allah, I love that part, I didn't understand it, I didn't spend time to understand it. Yes, you send it to me and it was with me. I lived with it for 60 years, 70, 80, 90, but I left many, many portions of it that I don't understand anything of it. I didn't pay attention nor exert an effort to understand it. That by itself is a big problem, that you left something intentionally with no excuse, and it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah will confirm the complaint of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and there are people definitely will be subject to the punishments of this complaint. Now, the main hujran, the main abandoning of the Quran is what is in the surah. Surah Furqan An-Nadhir. One or two functions of the Quran: to be Furqan, to equip yourself so that you know the falsehood from the truth, the right from the wrong, the values, the moral values from the immoral values, the best judgments, and to be guided. This is dismantled. We don't really seek many of us guidance from the Quran. We seek blessings from the Quran. We seek reward from the Quran. We seek physical protection from the Quran, from the jinn, and so on and so forth. But we do not go to the Quran, refer to the Quran as a Furqan, what is going to take over the darkness that we face in our life or in our soul, in our heart, or in our nafs. And that is mahjur. The junk food is taken and the good nutrition is left. So people are sick with no doubt about him, and the soul is sick. The other one is nadir, as we don't take whatever in the Quran as a warning for me, myself. Here Allah said this and that, and this is deserving punishment and hellfire take, and that and that. I don't put myself in that place. That means me. And ask myself the question, do I do this? Then I am in my way to the wrong end, which is just as the surah has mentioned, many ways leading people to hellfire. And so these are two main ones. The second one is, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَا لِكُلِّ نَبِيٍّ عَدُوًّا مِنَ الْمُجْرِمِينَ. And this verse is exactly in a different way is in Surah Al-An'am. لِكُلِّ نَبِيٍّ عَدُوًّا مِنَ الْمُجْرِمِينَ أو مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ يُوحِي بَعْضُهُمْ إِلَى بَعْضٍ زُخْرُفَ الْقَوْلِ غُرُورًا. So it is fact, Allah is stating that the messengers and those who follow them Allah will appoint enemies in their way to fight them back, to test them, to solidify their iman and strength, to determine their resolute to pursue the truth and to avoid the falsehood. So if you have an enemy because of your effort, religious effort, or your knowledge, or your effort to reform, or your effort to change, or your effort to teach Quran, to learn Quran, to memorize Quran, if you have enemies then like this, then you should be happy. This is the way all messengers and all prophets have faced this, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. On contrary, if everybody is pleased with you, you really have to ask yourself serious questions. If the hypocrites, if the idol worshippers, if the tyrants, if the injustice people, if the crooked people are happy with you, then there must be something wrong, and you really have to drill yourself and find out why. Even those who are close to the Shaitan, also they are so close to you. So from here, these are two topics. They need by themselves separate lectures. Enemies for the messengers and their followers, and how Muslims, or most of them, or some of them, have abandoned the Quran by choice and not by other reasons. Now, when we come to, as we said, now Ibadur Rahman, it started with wa, and wow, this is harf atf, means in addition to or based on, and the based on and the verse before it, which is هو جعل الليل والنهار خلفة لمن أراد أن يذكر أو أراد شكورا تبارك الذي جعل في السماء بروجا وجعل فيها سراجا وقمرا منيرا وهو الذي جعل الليل والنهار خلفة لمن أراد أن يذكر أو أراد شكورا. So Allah is saying, in addition to that, what he did, made buruj in the sky and the heaven and the structure of it, and also made the day and night as a signs and means to remind those who was to be reminded and to generate gratefulness. لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَن يَذَّكَّرَ أَوْ أَرَادَ شُكُورًا. And this is enough for any Muslim, for any mu'min, every night and every morning, every sunset and every sunrise is enough reminders that there is a driving force taking the universe into certain direction, into certain end, into certain final point, into finishing point. It's enough. وهو الذي جعل الليل والنهار خلفة. خلفة means they come after one another. They take the place of one another. خلفة from خليفة, from children. They take over you, after you. So خلفة لمن أراد أن يذكر. But you have to be مريد. You have to have the desires. You have to have the will. You have to have the motivation to remember what is going on. So Allah add to that, and he said he did that, but also has made a real living examples that you can see in your life, and you see their description in the Quran, and you see that in the life of the Sahaba and righteous, that they were also reminders. Those Ibadur Rahman are reminders to all those who wants to claim the ladder to be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah has described them ibad, just like he gave Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the best title, abd. Tabarak alladhi nazzal al-furqan ala abdihi. Here also he said ibad, and linguistically ibad means by choice. Abid could be by choice, could be not by choice. So all human beings are abid of Allah, not most of them by choice. Those who are believers, they have chosen to be ibad. The rest are still his abid. Otherwise, the sun and the moon and the rain and the ocean and all of these provided to you for what if you are not Abd al-Rahman? So the first quality, yamshuna ala al-ardi hawna, and it is amazing why this is the first quality, that they go on earth smoothly. We need to understand, hawna, it doesn't mean they are weak, they are terrified, they are withdrawing from life, they are not interested in life. It doesn't mean that. Hauna means they are serious, just exactly how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam been described. He used to walk as if he is coming down a hill. So if you are coming down, the gravity at your speed, and you are serious and focused, and you look down to that. The Sahaba, all of them said, وَإِنَّا لَنَجْهَدْ. If we walk with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they say we get tired to catch up with him, and he is just normally walking. He's not running, he's not rushing, he's not sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So hauna is just basically the quality of arrogancy is not there. So who walk on earth not hauna? Well, you know, there are people, there are certain group of human beings, they walk on earth not hauna, they walk arrogantly and hardly and harshly and so on and so forth. Now we get to understand, when we talk about the disbelievers, the rejectors, not the common one of them, no, only those who were in power and stood up with their means and might to oppose the da'wah. These are the ones are meant in this surah and in all the Quran. It's not the common kafir. Common kafir basically doesn't know much, just like a common Muslim, doesn't know even much about Islam. So here meant the disbelievers, not all of them, those who stood up arrogantly to oppress, suppress, fight back the da'wah, the Quran, the message, and the messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And you can see they are definitely walking on earth arrogantly, hardly. The good example of walking not hauna is the military parade. They do not walk hauna. They punch the earth, they push hard, and their head is up to express this force, but to express the at maximum level and show of arrogance. This is, that's otherwise it's not gonna be military parade. It will be civil parade. And when you have a civil parade, you see them singing or walking this way or laughing or waving. They are not walking, they are not marching like the military parade, and especially special forces and all of these. They show you the physically, what does it mean to walk on earth arrogantly when your head is up and willing to look right or left, to listen to anybody, to crush anybody in front of you, and you are focused and you are going straight to a certain goal to show off the strength, the might, the arrogancy. These are the one that is, it can visualize to us the opposite of hauna. The second one is definitely tyrants. Tyrants, they walk on earth with exactly the same thing. Clear road and block it and do that and do that. And anybody comes, you just get them out or get them to this to death and so on and so forth. So these are the one who has power. and has less iman, and they are willing to stand against the message and the messenger of Allah, to stood up against it. These are those who walk not hauna, not smoothly, not seriously, not normally, but they walk in a certain way, in a different way. So that is the first one. And you remember, it's lahu mulku samawati wal ard. So earth is a slave of Allah, is a servant of Allah, is a worshiper of Allah. And you walk on it, reminding yourself, you are a slave of Allah, exactly like the earth is a slave of Allah. And so Allah has empowered you, uplift you, get you the chance to walk on another, on a face of another servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we know from hadith in Quran that earth, if it is allowed, it will swallow, it will drown, it will punish those arrogant kafir. But Allah does not permit that. In the day of judgment, Allah will permit hellfire to takadu tamayyizu min al-ghayz, and send flames to grab them and give them all the creation of Allah. Exactly, that's what they want. So hauna, remembering this is a slave of Allah being subdued to benefit me and to raise me and to uplift me. So I am not going to be arrogant, because I'm just exactly in the same status of this servant of Allah. Now, Sheikh Mahmoud, jazakallah khair, in the Friday khutbah, has delivered good dimensions to this. Khatabahumul jahiluna qalu salam. Honestly, every one of us, you will be talked by the jahili all the time. Except from your family, and they're your neighbors, and they're your classmates, and then in the street, and the job, everywhere, there are ignorance. Will definitely khatab, initiate conversation and argument and dialogue and questions, and does something like that, irritating some of them, even irritating or attacking you or claiming you are so and so. You remember Yusuf Islam, he said, what is amazing to him, he said, they charge me for the fatwa that Iran sent against Rushdie. They framed me, and the media put me definitely in a very awkward, defensive, I never imagined it. I never said a word. I never get into these politics. I don't get their word, but they put me really on the cross, and they were willing to execute me. So this has happened to everyone, and that is how it is. Al jahilun always will speak to you, even if you are peaceful. Now, what is expected from you? To talk to them back. There is no doubt about it. خاطبهم قالوا. So they saw it, they said something. But that what they say only to bring peace, not to be dragged into fight, into argument, into conflict, into physical draining of energy. Never go. And this is something really, the solution for all the problems in the family. You know, the husband said, and the woman said, and the kid said, and the brother said, and the sister said. And instead of following this, I say only what is going to bring peace, or I don't say anything. I opened my mouth to say, ask myself first, what is the word or the statement or the verse or the reaction that is going to bring peace? Not, oh, how I'm going to start my own fire, how I'm going to add fuel into it, how I'm going to win the argument, how I'm going to humiliate them, how I'm going to show they are dumb and they don't understand. This verse is the constitution of life, of social interaction in every aspect. And Muslims should be able to control themselves and respond to all irritating talks and all these aggravating argument, only with that is going to bring peace and calm down the situation. I like this word. I heard it many times from one of my friends. Calm down the situation. This is what every, if you are from Ibadur Rahman, definitely, if you are the instigator, and if you are responding in the same direction, and you say things that will never will make peace, is impossible, will not bring peace, there is no doubt about it, you are not from Ibadur Rahman. And this is something very serious. You want to be here or you don't want to be. Depends on how you react, how you respond, how to all these jahil. Jahil means somebody ignorant or somebody purposely trying to aggravate the situation. Wallahu alam. So now this is, it said, "Huwa alladhi ja'ala al-layla wan-nahar." So this is in an-nahar. In an-nahar, they walk gently, smoothly, and seriously, and they get engaged in talking even to the ignorant ones, and they bring peace. This is their day. Their night is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yabitun li rabbihim. And this verse said yabitun means the whole night is sujjadan wa qiyama. Sujjadan wa qiyama. Why? I mean, it could say praying, but sujjadan wa qiyama, somebody making sujood, somebody standing. So wants to draw your attention to the movement, to the action, to the alertness, not somebody half asleep, somebody yawning, somebody who can't even keep himself standing. They are in a motion, standing and bowing and prostrating. So even at night, they are not just like as yamshuna hauna, like weak and tired and hopelessness and don't see much in them, any energy. They are sujjadan wa qiyama. The word sujjad. Sujjad means every sajda finished, followed by the next. Every sajda finished, followed by the next. So sujjadan wa qiyama repeatedly, the whole night never get tired. La yafturun yusabbihuna al-layla wal-nahara, as the angels. La yafturun. Sujjadan wa qiyama reflect that they never get tired of doing this and being close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they are aware that there is enemy, we said, ambush, which is called hellfire, as Allah, inna jahannama kanat mirsada. Jahannam is similar to the ambush, hitting enemy, trying to get you when you pass by. Definitely, we are going to pass by in our way to Jannah. Jahannam is ambush in the way. So they are alert and aware of that. And they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as if what? See, they are a believer. They do not commit shirk. They do not kill anybody. They do not commit zina. They are standing the night praying. As if all of these good deeds is not reliable. You can't rely on it. That is going to be enough to save you from the hellfire. You have to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I think we're going to stop here. Jazakumullah khair. And I would like everybody to participate. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi. Jazakallah khair. Okay, we'll open the session, inshallah, for people, inshallah, to ask questions and interact with Sheikh Muhammad. Bismillah. Raise your hand, please. Okay, brother, okay, sister Karam, tafadhal.
Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh. I have a question about the last point you made. Could that be a hint? Yabituna, they are by themselves all night, nobody's around them. A hint to show that they are not hypocrites. They are doing the best of the salah in all its aspects when they are by themselves at home all night. Could that be a hint that they are not hypocrites? That's one characteristic of them. Thank you.
I didn't get that word. They are not. They are by themselves, so they are sincere or what?
Not hypocrite. She said not hypocrite.
Oh, not hypocrites. Yeah, sincere. Oh, definitely, the sincerity is there because they don't show. They are not showing off to anybody. But even if you are in a group, the Prophet ﷺ used to make qiyam with the Sahaba around him. And as we know from his qiyam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his feet is swollen and sometimes bleeding. And Sahaba used to stand up until they get tired and they just leave. And they ask him, why you do that? And though Allah has forgiven you all these. So he was not showing up. It was something, first of all, he enjoyed it. Fulfill the order of Allah, and this is the way you can really ascend with the Quran close to Allah. Ascension to a higher level of Iman and closeness to Allah. Need, as Allah told the Prophet, قُمْ اللَّيْلَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا. So even those who do this in public, it doesn't mean they are not sincere.
Okay, brothers, Ziyad. Sheikh Ziyad.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. I was the Sheikh thinking about the meaning of hauna, those who are walking on the earth, hauna, smoothly. And I came to this picture, Sheikh. If you are driving a car, Sheikh, and the road is bumpy and rocky, and your car is well equipped with good shocks, you are inside the vehicle, do not feel the road. Those are the Ibad al-Rahman, Sheikh. The earth and the walking is not easy. It's harsh. They receive criticism. The media is attacking us. Even though they absorb all those shocks and attacks, and they absorb them, and not only that, they absorb them, but also they reflect salama. When وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمْ جَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. That's one of the means
that I wanted to. That's very good. And as Allah said in Surah Al-Muzammil, to confirm that, إِنَّ لَكَ فِي النَّهَارِ سَبْحًا طَوِيلًا وَاذْكُرْ اسْمَ رَبِّكَ وَقَالْ وَاصْبِرْ صَبْرًا جَمِيلًا. That is the absorbing shots.
أحسنت.
جزاك الله خير. أوكي. جزاك الله خير. Beautiful. أبو كرم تفضل.
السلام عليكم.
السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
جزاكم الله خير يا شيخ. أهم شيء, the most important thing that you mentioned, which is يمشون على الأرض هونا, هونا, which means basically humbleness, arrogance, and in comparison, it kind of compares to the shaitan when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked him to yusjud li Adam, and he said, no, I'm better than him. So it seems like there are a lot of similarities between the people of arrogance and the shaitan. And that seems to be the most important characteristics, which was, unfortunately we have a lot of it nowadays. And just if you can comment on that a little bit more, I would appreciate it.
Jazakallah khair. Okay, that is another dimension of this يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنَا. Arrogancy is a destructive quality, and never productive, never constructive, never fruitful. Arrogancy is a destructive qualities and behaviors that started with the shaitan, and it reflects that you are conceited and you are ignorant and you are exalting yourself as God, or has the guts to deny the order of Allah, where he said bow. And that's why people, the sujood of night, we know what is it. The walking hauna is the sujood of the day, where you're still going through the earth, exactly bowing and prostrating to Allah, means thanking Allah and thinking of yourself, your limitations. as we know, the main problem today is arrogancy, that making people, arrogancy divides and bring hatred and judgment and corruption in the society. And probably you know the description of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he was humble but also close enough to those who are interacting with him. Yes, they come as an enemy, wants to kill him. The minute they interact with him, talk to him, see him, they turn 180 degrees to love him, to admire him, to expect him, to adore him, to revere him, because of the arrogancy is not there. And Allah said, "Al-kibru ridai." Allah said, no one is going to enter Jannah if you commit shirk, and no one is going to enter Jannah if he commits arrogancy, even a weight of a grain, seed grain. So it's one of the biggest. Actually, arrogant is, as you claim you are God, you are everything. Everybody has to be down and be looked down upon, and has to surrender, submit, admire, listen, follow. Arrogance is just you appointing yourself an idol. Wallahu alam. Jazakallah khair.
Jazakallah khair. Okay, any more questions before we conclude?
Just to continue, Sheikh. Also, you know, in the same subject, you know, we have some people.
Mukarram.
And is that also is a Mukarram. Sign of arrogance? Yes, can you hear
yes.
me?
Yes, it is. Yes.
Can you hear me?
Yes, yes.
Yes.
Yes, it is yes. Our situation. It is no more than arrogancy, but it is worsened by ignorance. Exactly. What is going to bring peace? They don't think about it. They don't care about it. They don't want even to bring peace. And disrespect to everyone else. We get the power. We'll do whatever we want to do. Everybody has to follow us. And one of the board said so. We get the power, we are to be followed and listened to, and no question to be asked. So they do not want to even hold themselves accountable to anyone whatsoever. But, I mean, really, don't worry about it. They are digging their graves, and I feel sorry for them.
JazakAllah khair. Brother Irfan, go ahead.
JazakAllah khair. Thank you, Sheikh.
Barakallahu feek.
Assalamu alaikum.
Yes, sir. Can I speak now or?
Yeah,
go ahead. Jazakallah khair. I think Sheikh Hilali, you made a very good point about the arrogance and the ignorance. It's all rolled into one. And then for some reason, they get into position where they can show their arrogance and their ignorance. That is yes. A sad part. And we suffer for it all. And I think they don't realize it, but they suffer too. With us, but unfortunately, it creates a problem for everyone.
Well, honestly, their greatest suffering is coming. Don't worry about it.
Well, we don't want anybody to suffer. That is the main idea
but
of
that, being a Muslim. It's not for. It's not because of us, but because the way they approach things, more suffering is in the way, in their way.
And we should always make dua that Allah gives us strength, sabr. And that we can meet these challenges. This is a test for everyone.
Yes.
It's a test for us. It's a test for those people who are ignorant and arrogant, but rolled together. And the thing is that may Allah give us strength, may Allah give us sabr, and may Allah protect us all, inshallah.
It is mainly our fault because we have given them their way all the time. And now they cannot take it otherwise. We have left them alone to whatever they want to do, and we always have given them their way. So now you tell them no or change, it's too late. They're already used to it. They have grab it, and they are unwilling, and they cannot lose it, or they cannot really hold themselves accountable to the ummah.
Brother Ahmed,
and the Quran. Yes.
Ahmed, Dr. Ahmed, you have a question?
Brother Irfan is still talking.
No, I'm done, please. All I wanted to say is that there are many examples, and one of the biggest examples we have in the Quran is the Pharaoh. The example of the Pharaoh is the most important and very clear example for everybody and all of us. Thank you. Jazakallah khair.
Wa iyyakum.
Brother Ahmed, Dr. Ahmed, and do you have a question before we conclude, inshallah? Okay, I think we're done. We will, inshallah, next week we will have our classes.
Salaam alaikum. Yeah, just quick for the Sheikh Hilali. I was reading in Surah Al Isra in the ayahs 47 and 48. نحن أعلم بما يستمعون به إذ يستمعون إليك وإذ هم نجوى إذ يقول الظالمون إن تتبعون إلا رجلا مسحورا انظر كيف ضربوا لك الأمثال فضلوا فلا يستطيعون سبيلا. And the ayat Furqan, you already we have almost the same ayah in ayah number 8. وقال الظالمون إن تتبعون إلا رجلا مسحورا انظر كيف ضربوا لك الأمثال فضلوا فلا يستطيعون السبيل. Is there any relationship between those ظلم رجلا مسحورا and the ضلال in ضرب الأمثال أو عدم استطاعة السبيل? Because the same, almost the same ayat. Exactly.
Al-istita'a, as we say, the capability to label something correctly is not there. They don't have it. They want to create a label. That label is convincing to themselves and to the people around them. We're unable because they see it inconsistent. They might see some moment, as we say, when he receives sallallahu alayhi wa sallam revelation, there are changes and you can see like, okay, maybe he is subject to mutation or so on and so forth. And then it's only minutes and then there is Quran, there is miracles, there is word of Allah, there is light, there is, it's so they cannot have this word, majnoon or sahir or mashroor, to stick around, because just the minute revelation is finished, things are basically clear, totally clear, and he is the wisest and bringing miracles and signs and knowledge that nobody knows at all. So it that is what is la yastati'un. They have attempted to create a label to stick with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They could not, and Allah promised that they will never, because they are fabricating and they are not saying the truth and they are unwilling to listen to the message. So they avoid that by these labelings, and that's why unable to basically have any of this label to stick. That is what la yastati'una dharabu laka al-amthala fadallu fala yastati'una sabila. And every prophet was told sahir aw majnoon because of some physical things they see. When the messengers receive revelation, there are some physical changes and there are some noise and so on. They feel, oh, maybe this is just like sahir. That's because they are ignorant and they don't know how revelation being sent down and how a human being can receive revelation. But once the revelation is there and the prophets start reciting to them, we know it's a different story and there is no trace or unbelievable. You cannot believe that he is a subject to magic or he is a magician. Wallahu a'lam.
Yeah,
you have something? Go ahead.
Yeah. Hold on. Can they, since it's repeated twice, I mean, for the ayah, انظر كيف ضربوا, is it not only for the prophet, also for maybe for every Muslim? Because he mentioned, فَلَا يَسْتَطِعُونَ. He didn't say فَلَمْ يَسْتَطِعُونَ لَمْ يَسْتَطَعُونَ لَكَ بِالْمَاضِي فَلَا يَسْتَطِعُونَ. It's kind of like a rule forever. Like,
right.
It's going to happen before and even at the end until the day of judgment. They will try to find any example to label you, as you said. So they will never succeed, no matter what they try.
What we see today is labeling to all the Muslims and the sincere one and the scholars and the da'iya and those really going on the right path. All the effective, they think, the effective women is labeling. And the Quran is this way, and the Quran and the Muslims are this way and that way. But as we can tell, it did not stick around, nor it fly even among themselves.
Yeah, decay quickly, as they say in physics, right?
Yeah, evaporated. Yeah. جاء الحق وزهق الباطل.
جزاك الله خير.
Jazakumullah khair. Okay, if there is no more questions, we'll conclude inshallah. We thank all of you guys. Jazakumullah khair. May Allah reward you and Sheikh Muhammad. Next week, inshallah, our classes will start at 7:10. So, okay, Jazakumullah khair. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Nasta'inuka wa la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum.